A crowded field of 7 Republicans and 4 Democrats are vying for governor. But after tomorrow's primary election, voters will have narrowed the field down to just one candidate for each party. Even though the polls don't open for hours, many Mainers have already voted. Secretary of State Matt Dunlop says 21,000 absentee ballots have already been cast. But it's the scores of undecided voters that candidates are going after tonight as they make a final campaign push. News 8's Jackie Couture has our Commitment 2010 report on this primary eve. Jackie?
Well, Steve, polls have indicated the majority of voters out there are undecided, and that's why all the candidates were making a final push tonight to get those people to the polls to cast a ballot for them.
Meeting and greeting, talking with voters, whatever they can do to make a final impression, it's primary eve, and all 11 candidates for governor know this is the 11th hour.
Are you calling them? Or are you emailing them? What are you doing?
Both. You use every means available to you.
We've probably called 100,000 homes in the last 10 days. Between robocalls and town hall meetings.
The town halls are over the phone where hundreds of people can dial in and fire away. Democrat Steve Rowe is doing the same tonight.
Thank you so much. I appreciate your support.
While his staffers continue to work the phones at this phone bank.
We're calling undecided voters, trying to bring them over to the Rowe campaign, and we're having a lot of good luck with that, so I feel very good about how it's going to go.
The undecided voter, a key player in this campaign since so many polled are undecided. Democrat Libby Mitchell met with a group of undecideds at this home in Cape Elizabeth. Candidates have been all over the state and will be tomorrow as well. Democrats Rosa Scarcelli and Pat McGowan are campaigning in Bangor, where they'll begin Election Day, then head south. For the Republicans, Les Otten also had a town hall phone conversation in Bethel tonight. Matt Jacobson made calls from his home in Cumberland, and Bill Beardsley spoke to Republicans in Millinocket.
Well, you're very welcome, and I hope I get your vote, and thank you very much for your time tonight.
Calling from his home office in Falmouth, Bruce Poliquin is reaching out to people in his hometown of Waterville. He's also after the undecided voter, the very voter who will determine tomorrow's 2 winners.
All the candidates say they recognize how important each vote is, since the Secretary of State is only predicting about a 15 to 20% voter turnout for tomorrow, which he says is standard for an off-year election. In the studio, Jackie Couture, News 8.